There are a bunch of AI news channels out there. This one's going to be a little bit different because this is focusing on AI video products. But this is from the perspective of somebody who is a narrative filmmaker. I say real filmmaker, but narrative is longer than real, so real looks better on a thumbnail. So to kick off, I need to talk about Sora. I'm a few weeks behind the curve on this, but it's important to lay down some groundwork. The tool looks amazing. Not out yet, but it looks like the character consistency looks amazing. The fluidity of motion looks amazing. Being able to keep the world consistent as you move the camera through the world and around the world. Amazing. From a narrative filmmaker's perspective, there's still a lot of questions, and here's the things that I'm looking for as we move forwards. Multi-shot consistency of characters, costumes, locations, lighting, props, hairstyles, makeup, all the kind of things that would be important in any narrative film project. I'm also looking out for characters' facial expressions. That's a really important one. Bringing the emotion, the humanity into a character, very, very important. Lip sync, always important. Is Sora going to allow us the opportunity to feed in audio and to have the characters narrate that?
Why don't we go and find a quiet corner to go and talk?
And of course, we're assuming this, but will Sora even have video to AI video? That for me is the lowest hanging fruit. I like video to AI video because it allows you to carry the actor's performance, their movements, their ideally their facial expressions and the subtle intonations in their voice across. And so I would love to see Sora have a really impressive video to AI video offering. Speaking of Sora, the next tool that's just come onto the market that everybody's comparing to Sora is Haiper AI. This is looking really promising. The results are really consistent. Some of the sample shots on the website look really, really great. I gave it a try this week. I couldn't get video in painting or video repainting to work, which appears to be the closest thing to video to AI video. But I did play around with the text to video just to see what we were coming up with to try a shot that looked like it belonged in one of my movie scenes. It was okay. 2 second limit, not great, but it's early days. The thing that I think that they're focusing on very, very well is the kind of fluidity and consistency that we're seeing from Sora. And, you know, that's going to become the benchmark that everybody's going to be comparing it to now. Some of the things that I saw that were really impressive, there was a kissing shot. That's very, very important. And I mean, I'm working on a romantic comedy and the kiss, that's everything. That's what the whole thing builds up to, the first kiss. So consistent kissing is a tricky one to get. There are other things like movement of hair and character movement and even the eggs frying in a really authentic looking way. Very, very impressive. But again, the same questions for Haiper as it moves forward remain with Sora. Is it going to give us character consistency shot to shot to shot? And you know, all that stuff that I just talked about. Haiper being brand new, of course, is still full of bugs. And there were several things that I struggled with, and I didn't know whether it was because I was using Safari or Chrome. Maybe video repainting is accessible from a web browser on a PC. I have a Mac. The next thing to talk about is LTX Studio. I've signed up. It's not out yet, but the wait list has begun. Now, that is something that I'm really excited about, really intrigued by. So LTX Studio appears to be positioning itself as a one-stop shop, as a creative tool for filmmakers. I hope that's what it turns out to be, and I hope it grows from there. I hope it pulls in elements from other emerging AI tools so that you've got great facial expression, so that you've got great audio to lip sync connectivity, so that you've got a lot of consistency as well as the obvious sharpness of image. That's a given, but it'd be great to see this emerging. And so two final things to talk about. EMO AI. This is the thing that's been doing the rounds. It looks amazing. The ability to be able to have a still image and then feed a dialogue audio track in and have the AI figure out the facial expressions. Oh, that's exciting. That's exciting and incredibly important for us. So that I'm interested to see what that looks like when that finally comes out. And finally, I just came across Switchlight, a relighting tool. And now that's really, really interesting because one of my dreams is to be able to change the lighting in a shot and in a scene with just a prompt or just a flick of a switch or just changing a few settings. Switchlight is attempting to do that, and I applaud them for that. It's not there yet. It's still really, really intriguing, and it's doing some clever things. Not at a point where I could use it as a professional filmmaker, but where it's going to, I really want to see that succeed. Okay, that's me done. Goodbye.